Resident Evil. If you've seen my review for the original, then you know it's one of my favorite video games of all time. The ingenious puzzles, outrageous gore, and B-grade horror movie atmosphere made Resident Evil an instant classic. I fucking love this game.
Yeah.
Let us fast forward to the year 2000. Capcom had signed many exclusivity deals with Nintendo, and Resident Evil Zero, the long-awaited prequel to the 96 original, had shifted development from Nintendo 64 to its successor, the GameCube. Around this time, series creator Shinji Mikami felt the original hadn't aged well and was in dire need of an overhaul.
No.
This led to the announcement of Resident Evil Remake. My knee-jerk reaction upon hearing this was, for fuck's sake, Capcom, stop treating this franchise like Street Fighter! Remember, Capcom had released Resident Evil Director's Cut on PlayStation 3 years prior, adding new costumes for both characters, an arrange mode, and a cult python with unlimited ammo for those determined enough to beat the game in under 3 hours. It wasn't a true Director's Cut, really. Resident Evil 2 had been delayed once again, and Capcom felt they had to make up for it somehow. There's no denying that I ate this shit up. However, Capcom would later unleash Resident Evil Director's Cut DualShock in August of 98, along with Resident Evil 2 DualShock. The latter I'll accept, for many of the additions found their way to Dreamcast, but Director's Cut? They simply added DualShock support as well as a revised soundtrack nobody asked for. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, for shame! Now we have the remake? I was skeptical, and I didn't relish the thought of buying yet another goddamn version of a game I had 4 copies of. Then I played it. Seriously, this took my breath away the first time in 2002. It wasn't a reskinned version of Resident Evil with a few bonus items thrown in to justify its existence. Not at all. This old house was rebuilt from the ground up, and I am not exaggerating when I say it's positively stunning. When starting a new game, you're now presented with a little questionnaire. This is Mikami's clever attempt to shame the player into choosing a harder difficulty. I'm not falling for that, I like to ease into my pain. Then you choose your character, Chris or Jill, followed by one of the most startling cutscenes I've ever seen.
We continued our search for the other members, and it turned into a nightmare.
The first time I laid eyes on this sequence, my jaw literally dropped. I mean, it looks amazing. Both Resident Evil 2 and Code Veronica set the bar for these sequences, yet Remake took it one step further. It's a great sequence, though I don't feel this tops the fear factor of the original. Much of this has to do with the fact that I had played the original, so I knew what to expect, but one thing that scared me back when was that we never got a good look at the dogs. We saw just enough so as to know what they are, leaving some details to the imagination, which made it more terrifying. In Remake, nothing is left to the imagination. You see every last putrid detail, and while they look awesome, it undercuts the horror somewhat. That being said, these scenes still have Resident Evil's atmosphere. The rolling fog, gruesome reveals, and horrid dialogue.
Bizarre murder cases have recently occurred in Raccoon City. There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people. Victims were apparently eaten.
Shinji Mikami wanted to address the terrible acting and lame duck lines, so much of it was rewritten. The acting is a lot better in most cases, but who the hell talks like this?
Bravo Team's helicopter was a derelict.
It's so melodramatic. And derelict? Really? Oh, how about this?
What?
A can of fizz. It's sure to yellow and mellow those things.
Yellow and mellow? Is that a reference to Donovan's Mellow Yellow or simply product placement for a shitty soft drink? I know it may sound as if I'm complaining. I assure you, nothing can be farther from the truth. The stilted dialogue and ham-fisted deliveries added to the original's charm in a big way. If it were absent, I'd be a little sad. Alright, enough about the cutscenes. The narrative really hasn't changed, other than that some scenes have been extended and there's a subplot involving the mansion's designer, George Trevor. This ties into his daughter, Lisa, a ghastly mutation that haunts the estate and its grounds. From what I've read online, this subplot was meant for the first game, though it was cut for whatever reason. My guess would be time, but who knows. Her demise is anticlimactic, though it was a nice surprise and added more meat to the story. As for the gameplay, it's 3D characters over 2D backdrops, maintaining the classic presentation. You look for keys and solve puzzles, revealing more keys or special items while avoiding and/or fighting zombies, dogs, and a wide array of mutations. It feels the same, though radically different. The visuals, sound effects, and music have been improved significantly. All the character models and environments are detailed and lifelike, more so than even Code Veronica on Dreamcast. Chris, Jill, Rebecca, and Barry look like real people, made even more realistic by the environmental effects. The dust they kick up while running, or their shadows cast against walls as they pass a light source, reflections in pools of water. Oh, and the backgrounds! They're now fully animated with a lot of little details that give them life, from rustling tree limbs and wispy fog to flickering candles and moths buzzing around lamps. That, and there's an incredible sense of depth, making it feel like a fully rendered 3D environment. I must admit, it makes the original look like color forms. Remember those? Sound effects are better. Rickety floorboards and the shuffling of undead beasts roaming the halls always suck me into this nightmare world. I especially love how they handle thunder and lightning. Don't worry, decapitating zombies still sounds awesome. Let's talk about the puzzles. They're just as ridiculous as they are in the original, though many of them have been reworked and expanded, and the designers even went so far as to include whole new ones. This may not impress new players, but it will certainly delight veterans. There's one bit of brilliance most critics neglect, and that is these puzzles can play in your past experience with the original, like the Tiger's Head statue. In the classic game, you had to use both a red and blue jewel to reveal all its secrets. If you try that here, believing it to be the same solution as before, snakes will fall from the ceiling and poison you. Another thing I like is that the game forces players to use the examine feature. It was necessary before, though underutilized. Now it's essential in figuring out new puzzles. Some areas have been added to accommodate the new subplot, like Lisa's shed or her underground lair. How does she light all these candles, I wonder? Then we have the cemetery, this creepy garden found at the heart of the mansion. More familiar locations have been remodeled, like the shark tank. Damn! There's plenty of new ground for you to cover. Okay, how about the combat? Believe it or not, it's better. We must thank the control to a certain extent. The quick turn, as well as the ability to climb stairs without pressing the action button, both of which first appeared in Nemesis, are present. Already, that is a huge improvement. Tank controls remain. You hold aim and then fire. Nothing new there. However, you now have a defensive move that you can set to auto or manual. If you have a dagger, some weird battery pack, or a grenade, you can use it whenever you're attacked. Jill uses the battery like a taser while Chris shoves the grenade in a monster's mouth. Take a step back and BAM! Now that is fucking cool. These items are limited, though they don't take up any space in your inventory. Thank God, because for whatever reason, Chris only has 6 item slots to Jill's 8. Why? Don't we have a difficulty setting now? Why is this necessary? You have one other item, but I gotta talk about the zombies. They're not as easy to kill this time around. For starters, a shotgun blast at close range doesn't equal an instant kill like before. Not all the time, at least. That's bad enough. On top of that, they can come back to life! It doesn't matter whether or not they bleed out, unless you take the head or burn them, they're coming back. Worse yet, they'll actually run after you and even follow you into other rooms. That is some shit right there. As for burning them, you'll eventually find a flask you can fill with kerosene, giving you enough for 2 burns. This isn't an item you want to carry around for very long because it takes up too much space. Why? Because you need the fucking lighter to use it. If you're playing as Chris, it's fine. His trusty Zippo is a secondary item that doesn't take up any space. With Jill, you need to carry both items in your inventory. It's a pain in the ass, and it isn't all that vital. Really, I think you're better off shooting them again. again or dodging. I like that the zombies come back to life though. It shocked the shit out of me the first time it happened, and it gives me pause whenever I revisit a room, upping the fear factor like never before. For those curious about bonus items, I haven't unlocked them all. All I've managed thus far are a new set of threads. Each character gets two, but you need to beat the game with both Chris and Jill twice in order to unlock them. I'm sad to say I've burnt myself out somewhat, so I can't show them. You can unlock Chris's getup from Code Veronica and Jill's blue tube top from Nemesis. Again, you won't earn them until you've beaten it a second time. Chris does get some hipster clothes, while Jill looks like Sarah Connor from Terminator 2. That's pretty sweet, I won't lie. There are some alternative modes, but they sound horrible. There's one where all the enemies are invisible. Great, if you ever wanted a cheap way to play Enemy Zero, here you go. Then there's one dangerous zombie. One zombie chases you throughout the first part of the game. You kill him and the game ends. What kind of shit is that? I'm sorry, but even I have my limits. Resident Evil Remake may very well be the perfect retread. It was more than an easy cash grab. Capcom and Shinji Mikami paid great respect to the first game, all while expanding on everything that made the original so good. Do I like it more than the original? I can't say that. I'll say it's better, yes. I mean, if it weren't for the first game, I'm not so sure I'd appreciate the remake as much. It made the original feel new again, and that is a rare feeling in itself. I can definitely say I love it as much as the original. How's that for compromise?